This is the circuit board of the indoor unit of a Midea Mini Split air conditioner. The issue with it is that it is not powering on at all. So let's take a look and see what the problem is. First, we'll check the physical condition of this circuit board because it is very important. By doing so, you can identify faulty parts on the circuit. When I examine the physical condition of this circuit board, I don't see any visibly damaged components. The low circuit side rarely goes bad, but it's always a good idea to give it a quick inspection. However, the high circuit side is very important. Here we can see a ZNR, zinc oxide varistor, installed. If the ZNR gets short-circuited, the fuse will keep blowing repeatedly. I will check if this fuse has blown or not. There doesn't seem to be any visible physical damage on the circuit. But wait, this capacitor is swollen. You can see the top part of it bulging. This means the filtering capacitor has gone bad. So, I'll now check the value of this capacitor. It is rated at 22 microfarads and 450 volts. Now, apart from this capacitor, we'll need to inspect what else might be damaged. The high voltage that passed through this board is likely the reason this capacitor is swollen. Next, the focus will be to determine what other components in this circuit are damaged and what components remain safe. So, I have now removed this capacitor from the circuit board. The capacitor is currently in my hand, and as you already know, it is swollen. I've placed the circuit board securely in a holder, and now I will check all the components one by one. First, I'll check the fuse. I'll set the multimeter to continuity mode, and when I place the probes on the fuse, the multimeter beeps, which means the fuse is completely fine. Apart from this, there is a 1 mega ohm resistor here. Let's check it to ensure it hasn't gone short circuit or open circuit. I place the red probe on the lower pin and the black probe on the upper pin of the resistor. The resistor is showing a reading of 1 mega ohm, which is correct, meaning the resistor is fine. Now, let's also check the PTC, positive temperature coefficient component. I place the probes on the pins of the PTC, and it is showing a value of 22 ohms, which is perfectly fine. Another important component to check is the ZNR, zinc oxide varistor. Testing this is very important before powering up the circuit. We will check the ZNR from the backside of the circuit. When I place the probes on the ZNR pins, it is showing a value in mega ohms. If the ZNR is showing this kind of value, it is not a good sign. I will remove the ZNR from the circuit for further testing. It is possible that the 1 mega ohm resistor connected with it is the one whose value is being displayed here on the PTC. Now I have removed the ZNR from the circuit. I will test it now, and while testing, there should be no beep or continuity detected. If any beep or reading appears during the test, it would indicate that the ZNR is short-circuited. Ideally, it should not show any value or beep. I'll check it in continuity mode. There is no reading or beep, which means this ZNR is fine. Next, I will check the traces on the circuit board where the ZNR was connected. The value being shown here is the same as it was on the ZNR. This confirms that it was the resistor's value being displayed earlier on the ZNR. Since high voltage passed through this circuit, each component needs to be checked to ensure none are damaged. If we replace some components but leave a faulty one unchecked, it could cause the newly replaced components to fail again. This would result in unnecessary loss. To avoid such damage, thorough testing is very important. The next step here is to test the rectifier. This is its positive pin, where I will place the black probe, and I am checking it in diode mode. I will systematically place the red probe on each diode pin one by one. There should be some voltage drop displayed. If all the pins show a voltage drop, then it means the rectifier is perfectly fine. Now, I will reverse the probes and test all the pins again. This time, there should be no reading on any of the pins. If a zero reading is observed, it indicates that the rectifier is short-circuited. Next, we need to test the chopper, switching IC, optocoupler, and all the resistors and diodes in the SMPS switched mode power supply section. When testing the switching IC, we focus on the right side pins numbered 4, 5, 6, and 7. These are the source pins. While testing, we check these pins against pins 1, 2, and 3 in diode mode. If we get a voltage drop on these pins during the test, it indicates functionality. Currently, there is no voltage drop in this polarity. Now, we will reverse the probe's polarity and test again. Voltage drops are now appearing on this pin, the next pin, and the other one as well. Since no pin is showing zero voltage drop, this switching IC might be functioning correctly. Pin number 1 of this IC serves dual purposes. It is the undervoltage and overvoltage pin, as well as a control pin. The feedback coming from the optocoupler is received on this pin. This pin monitors the incoming voltage to determine if the voltage is too high or too low. If the voltage is too high, the pin detects it as an overvoltage condition and shuts down the system. Similarly, if the voltage is too low, it will also shut down the system. Pin number 2 of this IC is the bypass pin, and the manufacturer has placed a capacitor with it. If a 1.5 microfarad capacitor is installed here, the current limit will be set according to the standard. However, if you replace this capacitor with a 1 microfarad one, the current limit will decrease further. On the other hand, if you use a 10 microfarad capacitor, the current limit will increase significantly. This capacitor is selected based on the PCB design's requirements to set the appropriate current limit. Pin number 4 of the IC is the drain pin. There is a diode connected here, so let's test it. The diode shows the correct voltage drop in both reverse and forward bias, indicating it is functioning properly. Next, we'll check the other diode. This one is also working fine. Now, let's also test the chopper. These are the high side pins of the chopper, and the drain pin of the IC is connected here with the chopper. These pins are on the high side of the chopper. The resistance of these pins is 5.3 ohms, which is perfectly fine. Next, let's check the resistance values on the other pins as well. Here, a resistance of 1.6 ohms is being shown. Everything seems to be fine. Now, I will install a new capacitor in the circuit, and then we'll power it on to check whether it turns on or not. Here, you can see the new capacitor that I've installed. The electric wires are also connected to supply power, and the multimeter probes are set as well. The customer did not send the display unit along with this, so we are only supplying power to it. You will see the voltage readings on the multimeter once it powers on, and you'll hear the sound of the relay activating. Now I'm powering it on. The switching has also activated, and it is showing 222 volts. This confirms that it is working perfectly fine now. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos and subscribe. Thank you.